Good morning, everybody. Happy Sunday. It's already the fourth time we're doing the online worship together. And it's the first week of April, so why don't we stand up together and we're going to pray and open up this worship, okay? Let's put our hands together and close your eyes. Repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for being wonderful God in the midst of all this. We are thankful that we can still worship together as a family. We want to worship you and we want to glorify your name. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
얘들아, 지금은 헌금 시간이에요. 우리 모두 찬양 드리면서 준비한 헌금을 두 손 모아 하나님께 드려요.
사랑하는 하나님, 코로나 바이러스 빨리 없어지게 해주세요. 그러니까 학교 가게 해주세요. 그리고 교회에 가서 또 친구들이랑 예배 드리게 해주세요. 하나님, 황금이 하늘날게 해서 사용되게 해주세요. 예수님 이름으로 간절히 기도합니다. 아멘.
Very good. So we're going to get started. As usual, you need to be dressed up, not in pajamas, and you probably already washed your hands, you drank your water, you had your breakfast already, so make sure you're ready to worship God wholeheartedly. If not, you need to make sure to visit the restroom, drink water. If you're hungry, go get something to eat. Don't eat during the worship time, and make sure you're completely ready to worship. Okay, you ready? Okay, let's get started. Today, we're going to talk about Jesus. Today, we're going to talk about Jesus getting baptized. So if you look at this picture, the title is Jesus Was Baptized, and you see Jesus, of course, and you see John the Baptist. And if you look at the books of the Bible, you will see the four books. You will see the first book of the New Testament, Matthew, and going after Matthew is Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. So you get to see the same story in four books of the Bible. You know what it means? It means that something it's really important. It means that the Bible passage that we're going to be learning is so important that God put it in four books of the Bible. He put it in Matthew, he put it in Mark, he put it in Luke, and he put it in John. So we need to make sure that we pay attention so that we know what this important story, and that we learn from it. Okay, so let's look at the next page. Today's message is really simple. John baptized Jesus. So let's look at the story. This is John the Baptist, and he's kind of a unique person. If you look at him, he's not wearing a normal priest-like clothes, but he's a very free person, and he used to live in the wilderness. That means away from the city. He lived where the desert is. He lived where there is no buildings, no people. He just liked to live in the wilderness. And his clothes, he was wearing something that's made out of camel's hair. And it's that means he, you know, he's probably familiar with getting the animals, probably camel. And he wore clothes that's made out of camel's hair. And his belt was also made out of leather. That's the skin of the animal. And the last thing that's kind of unique and weird is that he was eating the locust, and he was eating the honey for food. So locust is like a grasshopper. Can you imagine eating a grasshopper? So he was a very unique person. He liked to just walk around in the wilderness, do his own thing. But there was something that he did that was really important. Actually, two things that he told people in the desert, in the wilderness, that was really important. That was his job. So he asked people to repent. What does repentance mean? We talked about this many times before. Repentance means turning away from sin and turning to Jesus. So if you see this stop sign, it says sin. So he was telling people, you need to stop sinning. You need to stop doing what God says no. And you know what you have to do? You need to turn to God. You need to turn to Jesus. This is repentance. And he was crying out this message to the people, whoever that he sees and whoever he meets. So he said, hey, people, you need to repent. You need to repent. You know why? Because heaven is near. You are going to go to heaven. And in order for you to go to heaven, there's something that you have to do. You need to repent. You have to say sorry to God for the things that you did wrong. And you need to come close to God. So this message he kept on saying to the people that he meets. And one more thing that he did, he said, whoever repented, you need to show your faith. How do you steer your faith? You need to get baptized. And baptism actually means to dip. Like that you need to be dipped inside the water completely. This is a picture of our pastor actually giving a baptism from our church. So what you do is if you believe in Jesus, if you confess your faith in Jesus, you get to be baptized and you go inside of water completely. So you stay there for a while, many seconds, and then you stand back up. That means that you are dead in your sin and you live again in Christ. So this baptism actually reminds that Jesus's death, about Jesus' death and him being resurrected. So back then, the people who John the Baptist spoke to, they didn't know about Jesus' death because this happened before Jesus started his ministry. But to us, baptism actually means that we're dead with our sin and we live again with Jesus. So those two messages, John the Baptist, he tried his best to talk about the point of repentance and the baptism to the people, whoever he meets. And those two things were the messages that he thought was important, and his job was doing that for the entire day and night, wherever he goes, whoever he meets. Okay, so he goes and he meets people by the Jordan River, and then people come to him, and he's giving the message. People, you need to say sorry to God for the things that you did wrong. You need to repent. You need to come close to God, and you need to, as a sign, be baptized. So he was telling those messages, and then people said, oh, okay. Maybe the life that we lived was not a good life. Maybe we did things that God thought was wrong. Maybe we didn't listen to God. So they realized their sin and they started to say sorry to God. God, I am sorry for the things that I did wrong. God, I'm sorry for the things that I said. God, I'm sorry for the things that I was even thinking. So they started to say sorry and they got baptized by John the Baptist. You know, John the Baptist is not actually his name. His name is John, but his nickname is John the Baptist because he baptized people. He made people repent so that he could get people ready to go to heaven. Okay, so people probably really respected him, and then he gave baptism at the Jordan River. A lot of people came by, they prayed and they repented and they came close to God. So they started probably to respect John, thinking that John is great, John is wonderful, wow, this is a great teacher, maybe we need to follow him. So they probably started to praise him and they started to follow him. They started to think of him as a great person. But you know what John the Baptist did? He was very humble, and he knows, and he knew who he was. He was just a person to get ready for somebody who's greater. And he talked about Jesus that was gonna come. And he said, you know what? I am not the great person. I am not the great teacher. I'm just a person who prepares the way for Jesus. I'm just making people ready to meet Jesus, to meet him, to repent, and to come to heaven. Because there's no way for you to go to heaven except believing this Jesus. So he was humble. He introduced Jesus, that someone great is gonna come. And this person, Jesus, is so great that he even said, I am not worthy to even untie his shoes. He can't even go close to Jesus because he's so great. And compared to Jesus, John the Baptist is so little. And he humbled himself by saying that. And one time, guess what happened? While John the Baptist was baptizing people, talking about repentance, Jesus actually comes by. And he says, John, I want to be baptized by you. Can you please baptize me? And John said, Jesus, you're not a sinner. You have nothing to say sorry. Why do you need to baptize? Why do you need to be baptized? If somebody has to be baptized, I need to get baptized from you because you're great and you're wonderful. You're God. But Jesus said, you know what? This is something that God likes me to do. This is something that I need to show other people to follow my example. So you need to baptize me. And John the Baptist, he obeyed Jesus. And you know what he does? He gets honored to baptize Jesus at the Jordan River. So Jesus gets baptized even though he doesn't have any sin. He's perfect and he's God. And he is greater, just like John the Baptist said, he's greater compared to any of us. He's God. But he himself came to meet John the Baptist and he gets baptized. And when he does, this is something great. You know what happened when he was baptized? The heaven opened up. I haven't actually seen heaven, the sky being opened up, so I can only imagine, but it's probably something very magnificent, very wonderful, right? So when Jesus gets baptized, the heaven opens up and something like a dove comes down on Jesus, and it's the presence of the Holy Spirit. So when Jesus gets baptized, you get to see the three persons of the Trinity, God, Father God, Son, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, we get to see all three persons of God's character in one setting. And not only the Holy Spirit comes down on him, not only the heaven opens up, there is a sound of God coming from heaven. And the voice of God is saying, "This is my Son, and I love him, and I am very happy with him." So whoever was present probably heard it. Probably heard God speaking to people who's there at the moment, telling everyone, "Jesus is my Son, and I love him so much, and I'm so happy with him." So God is telling everyone, and God is showing everyone that Jesus is God's Son. He's not just a perfect person, he's a perfect God. So by being baptized, God is telling everybody, "He's my Son, he's beloved, he's a wonderful God." So the Holy Spirit and Son Jesus and God, they dwell in this, are shown in the same spot. And by doing so, Jesus actually starts his ministry. That meaning that he starts to teach, he starts to heal the sick people, and he starts to speak about the kingdom of God. So he starts his ministry to help people come back to God and eventually go to heaven. Okay, so I'm going to talk a little bit about baptism again, because I want you guys to know, just because you are baptized, you don't go to heaven. And you are not baptized doesn't mean that you can't go to heaven. Baptism actually means that you're ready to show everybody that you are the follower of Jesus and that you have a firm faith. Firm means that you are sure. You have a sure faith that you believe in Jesus and that he died to save you from your sins. So it's kind of like a sign to tell everybody and to know that you're sure that you're Jesus' follower. But baptism doesn't mean that you get to go to heaven. And if you see this picture, Jesus is the only way for you to go to heaven. If you believe in Jesus, you can go to heaven. Baptism is like a sign that you can tell everybody. You can show people about your faith in Jesus. But baptism has nothing to do with going to heaven. Okay. One more time, I want you guys to know and ask your parents. They're sitting right next to you. Ask them, "Mom, did I get baptized?" Because when you are born, when you are little, like few months old, you get to have a child baptism. So if your parents were ready to offer you to God, to raise you in God's guidance and care, they do a child baptism. So ask parents, "Do you have a picture of me if I did it?" And you get to talk about your baptism, even though you may not remember it. You get to talk about it with your parents. And if you're not baptized yet, don't worry about it. As you grow, as you learn more about the Word of God, you will get a chance to get baptized as an adult as well. And our church offers a baptism every two times a year, I believe. So you still have chance. So I think right now is a really good time to talk about baptism with your family. Are you ready? Are you sure? Do you have faith in Jesus? If you do, as a sign, it's really important to get baptized. Okay? I have a new question for you for the month of April. And why did Jesus become human? Because we learned that Jesus is perfectly God, and he's a perfectly human. Why did he become human? And we all know Jesus became human to rescue sinners. He became human. He became a man to rescue us. Rescue means to save. Because we're sinner, because we do so many bad things, we have so many bad thoughts in our mind, we have to die. That's just how it is. The Word of God says if you sin, then you die. But Jesus didn't want us to die, so he died instead of us so that we can be saved. So the reason why he came to earth as a baby boy is for me and for you. Okay? I want you guys to just remember, why was it so important that God put it in four books of the Bible? I talked about it, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. We can see in all of those four Bibles, we get to see Jesus being baptized. It starts his ministry, and it shows us that we need to repent. And one more time, what's repentance? Repentance is turning away from sin, and we turn to Jesus. That's repentance. So I want you guys to repent and talk about baptism with your parents. And if you have any questions, ask your teachers or talk to me, email me, and we will show our faith in Jesus because he came to us as a baby to save us. Okay, so why don't we pray? I'm going to pray for us. You don't have to repeat after me, and we're going to end the sermon, and I'm going to introduce to you the new Bible verse for this month. Okay, let's pray. Father, thank you so much for teaching us that Jesus was baptized. Even though he didn't have any sins, he was baptized to start his ministry and to show us how to live. Lord, please help us to repent, meaning that we want to turn away from sin and we want to turn to Jesus, and help us to show our faith to you and to the people around us. We love you so much. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So, month of April, we have a new memory verse, and it's very easy. It's shorter than the last month, and you will probably get it today. So let me show you. We're going to read this together one time, and I'm going to show you the motion. And this is very simple. It's, he must increase, but I must decrease. It's in the book of John, chapter 3, verse 30. This is actually spoken by John the Baptist. When people praised him, when people came to him, he said, no, 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 I am not great. There's somebody greater who's coming, and that is Jesus. So he means it's Jesus. Okay, so repeat after me. He must increase, but I must decrease. John 3:30. Amen. So we're going to try this one more time. You'll probably get it. It's so easy, right? So we're going to do it slowly. You have to repeat after me one more time. He must increase, but I must decrease. John 3:30. Amen. Very good. So you guys, starting the first week of April, I have a new song for the Lord's Prayer. It's in Korean. It's a fast song. Instead of me and you just singing without the music, I think it'd be great to sing it along. So I want you guys to listen to it. I know it's pretty fast, so you won't be able to follow along in the first week, but if you keep listening to it, you'll be able to get it. So just keep that in mind, and we're going to end today's worship with the Lord's Prayer. It might be hard, but you can try, and we're going to just try to read through the word, and we're going to end today's worship with the Lord's Prayer. Okay, let's sing it. few announcements for you. A lot of you guys have been sending me pictures after the worship or during the worship to show me that you've worshiped at home with your family, with your brother and sister. That was wonderful, but I haven't still received a few pictures from some people. So if you can, please take a picture. You don't have to take a picture during the worship because it will not help you do the worship properly. So you can take a picture before the worship or after the worship, whenever you feel comfortable, and just send me those pictures. You get to see yourself. I will show your pictures as I do the announcement weekly, and the teachers miss you. I miss you. So it's a great joy to see you, see the pictures of you that's sent from the parents. So if you can do it, please do so. Send me the pictures after the worship. And this is the craft for today. So what I did was I asked your parents if they can to come to the church to pick up the packages for the April craft. So if you have it, that's good. If you don't have it, if your parents ask me to mail it, it will probably take a little long time. So you'll probably get it after Sunday. It's okay. So as soon as you get it, these two things are the crafts for this this Sunday. So as soon as you get it, you can do your craft. And if you would like to, you can also take a picture of you doing the craft and send to your teachers so I get to see it as well. And today is actually the Palm Sunday. What that is Jesus comes to the Jerusalem on a donkey, and then this is a Sunday before the Easter. So Jesus does really important stuff during that week before he dies on the cross and after until the resurrection on Sunday. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take probably about 4 to 5 minutes recordings every day starting Sunday night all the way to the Easter. So to walk you through, what did Jesus do on Sunday? What did Jesus do on Monday? What did Jesus do on Tuesday? So I'm going to walk you through the schedule. So if you're going to get a folder that has each day the title and the verse, and I sent you a little symbols that printed out in an envelope, and you, as you listen to my sermon, you get to put up a symbol for each day, and at the end next Sunday on the Easter day, you get to have a folder that's full of what Jesus did during that week. So that week is called the Passion Week, and you also can call it Holy Week. So stay tuned. You can come on YouTube. I'm going to send you a link through your teachers. You can watch me speak about what Jesus did each day, and you get to do a little craft on a in the folder like that. So please let me know if you don't have the folder, if you don't have the packages delivered to your house, let me know so I can send it to you. And please watch the video and let me know if you have any questions. Always email me or call me or message me, okay? I miss you. Bye.